rely on your money income, no monthly.
Thank you. Are you looking for a place to go on the weekend other than the club? Well, let me tell you about the newest hottest spot in town, and it's Martha's Daiquiri Texas, located at 8553 Macon in Cordova. Look, they have over 140 daiquiris. That's right, over 140 daiquiris. Plus, they got good food also. Look, you get daiquiris like the drunk Jack Frost. The pink Starburst, strawberry Hennessy, the lemon drop mango whiskey sour, jungle juice, and my favorite, and we're going to call it the cussing pastor special. It's called Hideous Motherfucker. If you're tired of the kiddie atmosphere and you're grown and you want to be in a grown person's atmosphere, Martha's Daiquiri Factory is a place for you to be. Weekends, they've got big flat screen TVs. They've got a live disc jockey. They've got food. Martha's Daiquiri Factory, 8553 Macon in Cordova.
Step in the doo-doo of life, and you get it all betwixt your toes, and you wonder why your life is stinking. You got doo-doo.
Amen.
You got doo-doo all between you, all on the bottom of your feet.
Amen.
You got your brand new weave on. You got your new outfit on. You think you all of that and a bag of chips, but you got doo-doo between your toes. And I don't care how well you look. I don't care even when you walk into the bank to get yourself some money out the bank. If you got doo-doo on your toes, you going to stink.
All right now.
And everybody will know that you're a stinker because doo-doo just smells. But all you got to do now is call on Jesus and let Jesus wash your feet. Let me close this. This
51st. This is Thaddeus Matthews, a.k.a. the Cussing Pastor. And I'm inviting you each and every Sunday morning to join me for virtual worship. That's right. You can worship without leaving home. Every Sunday morning on my YouTube channel, just put in Thaddeus Matthews at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time and listen to the Word of God that He's given me to give you. I'm looking for you on this Sunday morning on my YouTube channel from my virtual studios, which is my virtual church, The Naked Truth, Liberation, and Empowerment Ministries. Join me.
Memphis and the surrounding areas, Regroup Upscale Thrift Boutique has opened in the heart of Frazier. We carry many name brands ranging from various sizes and styles, with new arrivals of clothing, accessories, gift items, and more, with pricing starting as low as $3. All the proceeds help empower the Husband Institute Boys Mentoring Program. So come and shop at Regroup Upscale Thrift Boutique, located at 3754 North Watkins. Great prices, great people, great products.
It's the first year anniversary celebration for Bishop Stapleton and Friends. Easter Sunday, March 31st at 3 p.m. Featuring Some Amazing of St. Louis, Calvin Delights, Grace of Jackson, Tennessee, The Highway Harmonizers, God Sent, Ludacris and Reunited, The Gospel Writers of Jonesboro, Arkansas, New Direction, The Brown Four, Lady Jeanette Bethany, and many more. Make sure you save the date. Easter Sunday, Bishop Stapleton and Friends, first year anniversary celebration, March 31st, 2024.
Doors open at 2 p.m.
Program starts at 3 p.m. Greater Bethel, Church of God in Christ, 1672 Jesse, Memphis, Tennessee.
$10 in advance.
$15 at the door.
$25 special VIP and souvenir.
Come on, come on. Easter Sunday. And help celebrate Bishop Stapleton and Friends' first year anniversary celebration. Be there.
So many of our young men and women are being killed on the streets of Memphis, and loved ones are left begging for a way to either bury or cremate them. Because while they have insured their cars and their phones, they have failed to insure themselves. Well, there is no excuse. Call Joe with Lincoln Heritage Funeral Advantage. Joe can get your loved one insured for $30,000 for as little as $15 per month. Or even if your loved one is a male between the ages of 18 or 25, he can be insured for $30 per month with a $160,000 accidental rider for only $30. Females, $25. Lincoln Heritage is affordable and has fixed rates, lifetime coverage, no examinations, no waiting period on most cases, coverage for all ages up to 100 years of age, fast claim payments, 24 to 36 hours. Also, Joe has a senior hardship plan, even for fixed income families. Call Joe right now. Make sure you put this number down. Joe with Lincoln Heritage, 901-864-0090. That's area code 901-864-0090. Call Joe. Do you need a custom designed t-shirt made for any occasion and you don't know where to go? Well, you want to call D2G Screenshots, owned by my good friend John Olam. John specializes in direct-to-garment printing. You can put anything on a t-shirt that you can take a picture of. You just snap it, send it, and wear it. No design is too hard for John. John will fix your t-shirts up in a matter of days and have it back to you. Whether it's for your business, whether it's for your community organization, whether it's for your girls' night out, whether you've got a motto or a theme that you want the world to know about, John Olam and D2G is the place to go. In fact, he's been doing the Cussing Pastor t-shirts now for a number of years, so I strongly recommend him. Call 279-0434. That's area code 901-279-0434. John got you.
With Open Heart Community Foundation. Do you have loved ones that you're not able to take care of? Do you need somewhere for them to go and can't afford for them somewhere to go? We are providers for the State of Tennessee Choices Program. We take United Healthcare and we also take Amerigroup, which is now WellPoint. If you need someone to help you out, contact me, 901-409-1228.
If you want to know, watch that, yes. If you want to know, ask that, yes. He will let you know, yeah, yeah. Watch that, yes. It's the Thaddeus Matthew Show.
He's not afraid to tell the truth. He is the one that will inform. folks, what you thought it was safe Good Friday evening to you. Glad to be here with you on this Friday evening. How has your day been today? I hope it's been positive. I hope that you've been able to make yourself happy on this payday. All right. I want to get right off into the program tonight. And I see that it's not safe to go to Walmart and Kroger's and Super Low and all of those places. So, you know, there was an argument in the Walmart in Cordova. Person was shot, critical condition. They have not, the last time I was looking at the news, but they had not caught the shooter as of yet. But you just got to be careful, okay? You got to be careful. And I'm going to have to start going to the grocery store for myself, so. If you see me in Kroger's, Super Low, Walmart, please know that I am armed. Please know that I'm extremely dangerous. Trinace, I've heard of a friend of mine told me the other day, she told me that you can call places like Kroger's and they will order. I mean, you can order your food and they will deliver. So I'm gonna have to, you know, I'm about to learn how to cook. Oh shit. And I'm in all these years without cooking. And I do a lot of fast foods now. But like up here in my little cubby hole in my relaxation room. I got my microwave and my little micro freezer. Yeah, Barbara, that is an interesting thing, and this is not my conversation. This is not the show. He was arguing with a young lady. And apparently, this is what happened at Walmart, that the guy that was a former employee was arguing with a woman, and a man decides he's going to be Captain Save-A-Hole, and he intervened. And the ex employee, who's probably a boyfriend, they got physical. And one lady on TV says she heard 15 shots. Somebody said 10. But I guess if all that shooting is going on, you ain't counting no goddamn shots. You getting the fuck out the way. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, 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 no. You getting your ass out the goddamn, way. Okay. But we will hear more about it. And hopefully, the person that they're looking for, they say that they know who he is, they will get it. Tony, now, I know you old enough to know to heard the term Captain Save-A-Ho. Yeah, a ho's superhero. That's an old thing in Brooklyn. Good Samaritan about to get paid. Not necessarily so. Who are we going to get paid from? He can't get paid from Walmart. Walmart didn't tell him to go and be like a superhero. Put on his cape, run into the bathroom and come out with your theme music playing. He did that and made that decision. He decided to show out for the woman and got shot. Yeah. All right, let me get into this show. You know, I do a lot of issues and things of that nature, but I get tired of this shit sometimes. No, he ain't getting no victims caught. Coward, you need to know what the laws. He put himself in this shit. He's not a victim if he put himself in the mix of what is going on. Ain't gonna get no damn victims caught. Cause she just walked off and managed all that damn business. If him and the girl was arguing, shit, it wasn't the first time. If he slapped the shit out of her, it wasn't going to be the first time that he slapped the shit out of her. Quit trying to be a goddamn witness to shit. Damn. But sometimes I do these kinky and freaky shows because I'm kinky and I'm freaky. Amen. I'm sitting by writing a book. Natasha, you gave me an idea last night. The Sexapades of a Preacher. Okay. See, some of you want to think that the preacher, the bishop, the elder, the is beyond fucking. But all men wants to fuck. Yeah, I don't care who he is in the church. I don't care how long he's been the pastor. The pastor will fuck. If the pastor is offered some pussy, the pastor gone fuck. The teacher, I thought about my other book. You know, I hear folks talking about they gonna come out with books and shit. Well, I already got a book. It's called The Cussing Pastor Bullshit from the Pulpit. And it's a very shocking and revealing book. It's almost an autobiography because in it does tell of some of my sex-apades. Natasha, what I need to do is I need to do, I got fucked on, I had a ghostwriter. I had some people contact me wanting me to do a book. And I need to get in touch with Amazon. Amazon has the book. And those of you that have read the book, it is shocking. It is revealing. It even tells in the book about my relationship with two women. It does. It tells in that book how one of the women got pregnant. And the baby was not born. It's a good book, though. But I need to get in touch with Amazon and get me some of those books. It's a good read. It's a good read. Especially when you get to about chapter 6. I think I changed the names in the book, but those that knew me, knew who the women were. Leave that alone. I decided to, when the book came out, and I found myself about to get married, I didn't push the book because there were some things in the book that was not Quincy, you're going to have to tell me how to do it. Quincy, you're going to have to tell me. Okay, you're going to show me how to self-publish. Yeah, I need to get those books. Damn, change the names to protect the holes. God damn. I need to get that, my book. I need to get some copies of the book. I lost control having a ghost writer. And my biggest thing in doing books is setting the time. I have my copy sitting on my dresser about to start rereading it. Natasha, check in that for me. I don't know about this shit. When I had Dale as my assistant, she took care of all this shit. I'm just smart. I know how to administrate. But shit. Yeah. But it tells you about one of the book women in there, when I got my name tattooed on her, I'm sure it's gone by now. You can't have can have tattoos removed, can't you? I'll cover up and edit. Nick Thaddeus, a flower, a thing. Okay. I won't do another picture, another wall. Maybe sex of hate of preachers. Sometimes people don't think that preachers are horny. They're kinky, they're freaky, they don't watch porn. And I do all this shit. I do all this shit. And I'm ashamed. Okay? Well, Tony, this young lady put it on her thigh. Oh, how much? Yes. But it is on Amazon. It's called The Cussing Pastor. Bullshit. From the pulpit, I meant to put a picture of it. Okay, but today I want to talk about something that has come up in the church. Amazon has 50 reviews, all the different. I don't even know what that means, TC. I'm not one of them preachers that tell you, don't fuck. You're going to hell if you fuck. Well, I'm hell bound then. I'm hell bound. Okay. Thank you, Natasha. Do you just ask a lady, does she pussy eat no wood? No, you don't have to ask a woman if she want her pussy ate. Every woman wants her pussy ate. Let me say that again for y'all in the back. Every 50 people commented on my book. Well, y'all need to send me the link. Was it good reviews? Natasha, you got my regular telephone number too, aren't you? But one of the things that I do as a pastor is I don't want you to think that I'm a saint. Okay? I ain't no saint. I did about every kinky, freaky, nasty thing with a woman that you can do. Okay. Now, you don't have to ask a woman if she wants you to eat her pussy. If you're already in the lovemaking and you are in the foreplay stages, she's waiting for you to eat the pussy. Let me say that again. Sheila Woods, how you know? I ain't never eat your pussy. I don't guess. The name ain't familiar. Every woman, when she lays down with you, brothers, she's waiting for you to start licking on that pussy. Ladies, can I get an amen? Somebody, I need to get a witness in the house tonight. But some of you women have been taught that it's a sin. Yeah. Some of the old women from yesterday then used to say that if you let a man eat your pussy, you're going to hell. God made a pussy to be ate. Somebody said hallelujah tonight. Yeah. All right, Quill. I guess Quill Amata hired you as my public relations person. Let me let y'all hear an old lady and her views on eating pussy and sucking dick.
Pork. You can eat pork. If you eat pussy and suck dicks, you might as well eat 10 motherfucking pigs. Because the Bible speaks of consuming human flesh as much as it speaks of eating pork. So if you suck a dick and swallow the ejaculation, you might as well eat your 10 motherfucking pigs. If you eat pussy and swallow the fluid from the pussy, you might as well eat you 10 motherfucking peas. Because the sperm was made to fertilize the egg, and ain't not one of them coming from the goddamn mouth.
Oh, Jesus.
It's coming from your personal body parts. The sperm fertilized the egg, which is in your ovaries. Ain't no eggs in your fucking mouth. It's nothing there but sin, lust, and goddamn pleasure. And it all falls under the same umbrella.
But
eating consumption.
But eating pork will give you high blood pressure. Come.
Eating pussy will fuck you up on the inside in a long run. Eating dick will fuck you up in a long run from the inside. That's why we got AIDS and all this other bullshit around here.
But, okay, so the term eating vagina, you're more so licking. You're not really eating it.
Well, then you're consuming the shit that comes from the licking. You're consuming the body fluids. You're nasty motherfucker.
No.
You're nastier than you is if you eat a fucking pig.
Okay.
All right. Y'all heard it, Grandmama. Oh, shit. Huh? There is no scripture that tells you not to eat pussy. There is no scripture that tells you ladies not to suck a dick. In fact, ladies, to not suck a dick is a sin. I believe I'll say that again. Ladies, if you don't suck dick, you sinning. Can I get a witness tonight? Brethren, if you don't eat pussy, you are a sinner and you're going somewhere. I don't know where it's hell or somewhere. Lord Steen, you don't like your pussy? kind of. And let me tell you a lie. You like your pussy ate. Now, some brethren, you have to teach how to eat the pussy. Every man doesn't know how to eat pussy, just like every woman don't know how to suck a dick. There is skills in sucking a dick and eating pussy. It's some women. It's some women right now wish that they had somebody tonight to eat up that pussy. You're right, Evan and Chaplin. The only women that don't like getting their pussy ate is a woman that has not had her pussy ate right. He get down there and he don't know what to do. What to do. No. Or you eat it like a rabbit. This topic is deeper than I thought. I'm going back to work. Well, those things, take your ass on back to work. You're going to be thinking about it. You know you want your pussy ate. And ain't nothing wrong with it. Don't think that these Christians is telling you the truth when they tell you, you going to hell because you got your pussy ate. Something wrong with you. Lord Singh, you don't like your pussy? Call me Lord Singh, because I think you got something wrong with you. Yeah, you want your pussy ate. So Lord Singh, you mean to tell me, I'm sure you're a grown woman, that ain't no man ever offered to eat your pussy? Come on, Lord Singh. I mean, call me if you're a woman, a full grown woman, and you got a real pussy, and no man has ever even sniffed it, put his nose close to it, never talked to the pussy. Strictly missionary. Bitch, you boring as a motherfucker. Shit. Damn. Strictly missionary. Well, call. I was a Baptist preacher for years. Call me and let the pastor talk to you. Those things, are you married? Will do all men don't eat it. You're a Lionel. Hell no, I'm not calling you. You too deep. I don't know a man that don't eat no pussy. When I was young, it was taboo. When I was young, in my young teenage, we said that only white folk sucked dick and ate pussy. But then when I got turned out on pussy, even on the back of the school bus, that's why I got turned out. I ate my first piece of pussy on the school bus. Will G, you ain't eating it. You ain't got no woman then. If you ain't eating no pussy, bro, you ain't gonna keep your woman. I said, your name is Lois Steen. You always fuck. Yeah. I heard that it will have you crazy. It will, Lois Steen. If a man eats your pussy right, you're speaking unknown tongues. If he knows how to stimulate your clitoris, Lois Steen, you do know where your clitoris is located, don't you? Will D, call me, brother. You ain't never gonna eat no pussy. Come on, brother. Damn, bro. Denise Till, I'm getting my pussy licked right now. I didn't go to the barbershop, Queen. I went in the bathroom. I looked at my head. I said, shit, I'm tired of all this hair. And I just shaved my hair on. Yeah, good pussy eating. A woman will fall in love with a man that can eat pussy good. Yeah, Denise, if you're able to type on this thread and get your pussy ate, that motherfucker that's in between your leg, tell that motherfucker to get up because he ain't doing shit. Queen of Little, want the job on what? Shaving my head or eating your pussy? I'm just doing it, okay. Leave it alone. That number. If you have never ate pussy, or you have had your pussy, you as a woman have not sucked a dick, please call me. Let me give you some Friday night counseling. You going to Lois Steen, Hamilton? Yeah. If he can lick your clitoris and get that little thing jumping, Pastor, would you deal with a young freaking lady in her 20s? You know we're excited. See, you motherfuckers is treacherous. I'm fucking with no more young women. And they hit to her man and falls asleep between her legs. That's when you know you got that intoxicating pussy. I've turned some young girls out. No, I won't. They be stalking you and shit. They be stalking me. This new generation eating ass. Ain't nothing wrong with eating ass if that's what you want to do. Okay? Okay? If a man wants to blow in your ass, let him. See, it's whatever turns you on, whatever satisfies you as a woman. Ain't this better than talking about politics? Yeah, just make sure your ass clean. Make sure your pussy ain't clean before a man start eating on your pussy. Every woman deserves to have a pussy. Right. Girl says she damn near turning me out. I had to pull back and gather myself. I had a lady tell me mature women don't swell, tell, or smell. And I like pussy with a little hair. I do. I like pussy with a little hair on it. I don't like it looking like we need to call the city and have a blight committee come and see the pussy. But I like mature pussy. Okay. I like my tour pussy. Well, a little hair on it. Your pussy don't need to look like it's a juvenile delinquent. Don't be napping. Yeah, Clyde. Don't have that cuckaboo kind of pussy. You know, it's real beady. Put a little perm, some stay salt, for some, comb out some perm, Miss Clairol. Yeah, a black committee. Pastor, if a woman, God said, if a woman doesn't want her pussy to be eaten, she needs to go on by her way. I have to eat the pussy, and I love when they get the coming and shaking and squirting all over the goddamn place. Okay. See, if he's eating your pussy right, okay, that is a nerve on the inside of your left thigh that when you are coming, climaxing, ready to jump off the mountain, that it will start to quivering. You'll start shaking. That little man in the boat will jump overboard. I like to eat your pussy and then kiss you, baby. Taste your pussy. Lord have mercy. It's a Friday night on the Thaddeus Matthew show. 4 minutes before the hour of 8 o'clock. So anybody want to call me that have never experienced oral loving? Yeah, you're right, Miss Revlon, Shanice. Marriage bed is undefiled. Whatever, if you marry, whatever y'all do in the bedroom is right. Whatever you do. If he pee on you and you let him pee on you, and that's your husband, let him pee. Open up your mouth and say, ah! Coin said, don't kiss me afterwards. You must not remember. Anybody ever do the scat thing? What is the scat thing? See, even that pussy is that thing. Good loving will make you cry. Baby, it's whatever makes you happy. Oh, this is when you kiss and shit on your no dumb bars. No. Scatter shit. No, brother. Bless your heart. Jake Wolf, so you as a brown man need to know the difference in squirting and piss. Squirt has no odor. I think it's a water cooler. I just opened up my mouth. This is the Thaddeus Mantle Show, baby. Ain't nothing like this. One of my enemies last night tried to bait me to go live. He said, let's talk about the elephant in the room. Thaddeus. He didn't know Pope Thang. That called me the elephant in the room was a compliment. Narcus, I am the elephant in the room. The elephant is the strongest and the biggest in the jungle. Narcus, look at your media resume. Look at mine. You a little Negro that work for white folk hauling cars. I work for myself. You do your little ride in the morning and you'll make no munchies. I make munchies. In fact, I've been making money in advertising at my shows for 47 years. And so that makes me the big elephant in the room. I'm on 5 radio stations every day. This show gets over 1 million views every year. When I'm not on Facebook, folk will see it. Instagram. I'm on cable TV. So yeah, I'm the elephant in the room. So you just be satisfied with being the chimp. I know what the phrase elephant in the room means. But you didn't insult me, bro. In this area, nobody else even compares with what I do. Your numbers will never compare with me. Nobody knows you outside of Memphis. You've never did national TV or national radio. Nobody listened to you over in Japan and all them places, the Philistines and Philistines and all them people. because I'm the biggest and I'm the baddest. To keep swinging from limb to limb. And maybe someday, you know, this episode ain't going to let you ride because I don't like you no more. You got bitch tendency, brother. You went and got a picture that was photoshopped on me in 2016. Come on, brother. You as a man, you hate me that much, brother. You that envious, you that jealous. You'll never be me. Your numbers will never reach what I do. People think that you're a clown. Well, you, they think you're a clown too, but I could pay you. I could pay you. I got commercials lined up. And every commercial you pay at least $1,000 for the month. Two or three here got 2 or 3 months. Hmm. That's right. You don't play no commercials, do you? Oh. That's because you are remarkable. We'll be back in just a minute. Let me show you my resume, man.
Tiffany Rucker with Open Heart Community Foundation. Do you have loved ones that you're not able to take care of? Do you need somewhere for them to go and can't afford for them somewhere to go? We are providers for the State of Tennessee Choices Program. We take United Healthcare and we also take AmeriGroup, which is now WellPoint. If you need someone to help you out, contact me, 901-409-1228.
Ray Ray, you are not the father. Hey guys, are you in a relationship where a child is involved and you're not sure if you are the father or not? Well, stop guessing and know for sure. Call Quick Collect Drug and Relationship Testing Service at 901-304-7592. That's 901-304-7592. Paternity testing by mouth swab only. Quick Collect offers paternity testing, maternity testing, grandparentage testing, sibling testing, twin testing, Abaclore testing, where you can be tested if you are the aunt or the uncle. They do legal testing that's ordered by the court or not legal. You just want to get it done. Quick Collect Drug and Relationship Testing Service also provides drug and alcohol testing. Look, if you got employees and new employees and you are wondering about them, get them drug tested. Panels range from 5 to 18. Results come back within 24 to 48 hours. DOT drug testing for all CDL drivers or FMSCA carriers. Breath alcohol testing. Also, alcohol and urine testing. Instant drug testing for immediate results. You heard me. Instant drug testing for immediate results. Hair and follicle drug testing as well. They notarize documents for anyone that needs this service. They will also loan signing agents if you are a realtor or a title company. If you need this particular service, Quick Collect Drug and Relationship Testing Service, located at 6061 Stage Road, Suite 6. That's 6061 Stage Road, Suite number 6. Or give them a call at 901-304-7592. 901-304-7592, and know what you need to know quick. The biggest hazard to Memphis drivers other than car-to-car collisions is potholes. Well, you need a tire. You need to go to Tri-State Tire Wholesale, located at 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. They specialize in new and used tires. I don't care what it is that you drive, whether it's a car, a truck, tractor in the field, a motorcycle, SUV, or a semi-truck, Tri-State Tire Wholesale has the tire or tires for you at the best price in the Mid-South area. Every brand known to man is carried at Tri-State Tire Wholesale. Don't look anywhere else. Tri-State Tire Wholesale, 3278 Democrat Road at American Way. Call them at 901-795-0707. 901-795-0707.
Are you looking for a place to go on the weekends other than the club? Well, let me tell you about the newest, hottest spot in town, and it's Martha's Daiquiri Factory, located at 8553 Macon in Cordova. Look, they have over 140 daiquiris. That's right, over 140 daiquiris. Plus, they got good food also. Look, you get daiquiris like the drunk Jack Frost. The pink Starburst, strawberry Hennessy, the lemon drop mango whiskey sour, jungle juice, and my favorite, and we're going to call it the Cussing Pastor Special. It's called Hideous Motherfucker. If you're tired of the kiddie atmosphere and you're grown and you want to be in a grown person's atmosphere, Martha's Daiquiri Factory is a place for you to be. Weekends, they've got big flat screen TVs. They've got a live disc jockey. They've got food. Martha's Daiquiri Factory, 8553 Macon in Cordova.
There are five pillars to financial literacy. The first pillar is to earn. Earn during your wealth building years. These are your younger years, your 20s, your 30s, your 40s, your 50s, your 60s. The second one is to save and invest. Take 20% of everything that you earn and actually invest it on things that will make your money multiply. The third one is to protect. You need at least 3 to 6 months of your expenses saved. So in the event that you have an emergency, you're covered up to 6 months. And the fourth one is spend. Yes, spend money that's gonna make you wealthy, not others wealthy. And five, borrow. Good debt will make you wealthy, bad debt will make you poor. Borrow money that you're able to become wealthy. The most precious asset that you'll ever have is financial literacy. Invest in learning more about finance. I'm Tequila, the Money Medic.
when death comes to your family and you're left in charge of putting together a celebration of life program, you want that program to be memorable, beautiful, and to project the marvelous life that your loved one lived. Well, for your funeral program, you don't have to search or look around. You just need to call the Obituary Queen, Dee Ferris, of Ferris Media and Marketing and Alpha Omega Monuments. Dee takes pride in special design and production of your loved one's memorable program. After the funeral, and your loved one is buried, and you want that burial spot to be memorialized forever, call Dee for your monument. Dee Ferris and Ferris Media and Marketing Management can take care of all of your print needs, both church and professional, and anything that you need, Dee can get it done. You're looking for a graphic expert, call Dee at 901-440-6643. That's 901-440-6643, or go by 2960 Chelsea at Wofford.
Hello, I'm Tanya Jones, developer and still full owner of On Demand Pain Relief Rub. It's exciting and humbling to see how On Demand is growing and evolving while still being the same product you trust, purchased, and love. The pain rub is 100% still the same, 100% drug-free, 100% all-natural, and I am 100% still involved. I created On Demand Pain Relief Rub after I began suffering with my own chronic pain. And yes, the results have been amazing. You may see the new branding, the new look, and the new website, all coming from me, the same person that has a heart to help others deal with their chronic pain. Go ahead, place your order, or stop by any of the locations to pick up yours. I thank you so much for your support and trust. I am Tanya Jones, 100% owner of On Demand Pain Relief Rub.
Well, I said I would not do it again. And that's return to brick and mortar ministry. Well, God has a way of making a way when you have a plan that is not His way. I will return to the pulpit on the first Sunday in June at our new location, 581 Plum in North Memphis, right behind CC's Blues Club. But on Saturday, March the 30th, I will hold the rebranding and new organizational meeting of Naked Truth Liberation and Empowerment Ministries at 12 noon. If you would like to be a board member or advisor, meet me at 581 Plum on Saturday, March 30th. Oh, by the way, Naked Truth will have armed security in and out of the building at every worship service. Area-wide security and protection services, licensed and bonded, will be handling our security. I'm going to be looking for you for the organizational meeting on Saturday, March the 30th, Naked Truth Liberation and Empowerment Ministries.
Now I got
name it. That's a resume. That's a resume of monkeys. When you can do that, brother, you will have a multiplicity of adversaries to think that your page is worth advertising on and can get their message out. Then you can talk about me on the land. Until then, shut the fuck up. Because I am the elephant in the room. Hey, what time is that? 8:20? Guess I'm going down to Dodgers and give me some chicken. Damn, I said chicken. God damn. You heard me say chicken. Huh? Zima. You hear me say, when I get off, I'm going down to Dodgers and get some chicken. In Olive Branch. You just jumped up and... Yeah. Okay. I'm going to get you a box too. And she's so small. I hope her aura don't never come up. I've offered him $5,000 for her. Because you think you belong to me, don't you? You love me, don't you? About 15 more minutes. I go down to Kroger some days and give me a rotisserie chicken. And she thinks that she only want to eat dog food no more. Do you? Okay. Aquila, make sure you call me about something you do about that book. I need to get Amazon and get no help. Okay. Oh, I am home. I ain't talking about the Dodgers in Whitehaven, lovely raccoon. I go about 2 miles up to an Olive Branch. So have y'all enjoyed the subject for tonight? Eating pussy, sucking dick is not a sin. So tonight you will not be sinning. Enjoy it. Enjoy it. Is that right, big girl? And she thinks she could ride with me everywhere I go. If I'm putting on some clothes, she's gonna run down to the garage door and leave me there. Alright. Naked Truth Liberation and Empowerment Ministries. Sunday morning I will be on the air. Okay. Virtual church. Next Saturday, if you would like to come in. Come here. Somebody wants to see you. Come here. Come on. Come off here. Come on. Will a woman go into a coma if licked too long? I don't know. It's according to resistance level. Alright. I will be here on the air Sunday morning. 10 o'clock. Make sure I'll have a sermon for you Sunday morning. Alright, it is right about 8:30. I do not have to be on the air in the morning. I can sleep for, I'm going to still wake up early. And, just lay there. All right, y'all don't want to talk tonight. So, what else can I say? Thank you, Bob. And you can send your offerings to $ Naked Truth Ministries. Okay? $ Naked Truth Ministries. If you want to be a part of the ministry, you've got some ideas of some things that need to be done, and you know, if Memphis. I'm going to be getting with the Memphis Food Bank on next week. We're going to do various ministries. Pastor talked about why women sucked at dimmeline that had the condom on it. Is that safe sex? I guess it is. I guess it is. I ain't got no water. Zena, what's wrong? I'm gonna be off in a minute, and we'll go get in my car and go get us some sundaes. Those of you that would like to give to the ministry, there it is, $ Naked Truth Ministries. Here's one that I have started playing in the mornings by Jake Wong.
Thank you.
Ain't there, it's time to move on. Yeah, something so.
This is Chris and his Capital One Venture X business card.
Okay.
With no preset spending limit, Chris can buy the materials his business needs.
Okay.
Plus, they earn unlimited double miles on every purchase. What's in your wallet? What does it mean to be a fan? It means you have plans this Sunday. It means game day rituals and ridiculous
This is King George. On a Friday night. This is just the latest.
Past the right on by, yeah, it hurts so much for me to. Thank you.
best in music is what you get with me on the radio. That's Derek the Change Man and Smith. And I'm praying for him. All right, preacher.
Y'all, I did not think this was going to work. I am checking the mail, and I got it. I got it.
Here's another preacher, and I'm gone. He saw this one in his wife's funeral. It's time for me to get out of here. Thank you for so much for being here with me tonight. I hope that you have enjoyed the show this week. Yeah. I gotta go. Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go. Good night to each and to every one of you. Have a good weekend. I'll see you Sunday morning at 10 a.m. Oh! Oh!